Madeline Island Chamber Music's 2021 season is made possible through the generosity of the following donors who have contributed $1,000 or more. Good evening and welcome to those of you joining us in the clubhouse and also to those of you tuning in to our live stream. My name is Jonathan Swartz and I'm the Artistic Director for Madeline Island Chamber Music. Our live stream is made possible by generous donations from Tom Murtha, Stephanie Ann Lenway, and the Duluth Superior Area Community Foundation. When I think about this evening's program, the word that comes to mind is perspectives. As you may read in Osvaldo Golijov's program notes, he was inspired by thinking about different perspectives when he wrote the work that you are going to hear this evening. And one of the things I love about Brooklyn Rider is it always seems that they have a fresh perspective on the historical masterworks we all love. I can't think of a better combination. Golijov, Schubert, and the hands of Brooklyn Rider. I thank you for joining us this evening, and I hope you enjoy the concert.
Brooklyn Rider. We're so happy to see your smiling faces here with us today. Thank you for coming. And thank you for all of you who are tuning in to the live stream. This concert is a culmination of 2 weeks of deep dive into a life of a string quartet, which is something we do. When we're not here on the road, we travel, we learn new works, we perform. But this is an amazing place to just remind ourselves why we do it in the first place, right? I mean, we get to work with really talented young musicians who would rather have a chamber music reading party than do all sorts of other things. So we feel like we're in the nest, very happily surrounded by nerdy chamber music lovers, just like ourselves. So it's been really amazing. And you know, it just also reminds us how last year was really tough. You know, we were all isolated, and there's no better antidote to that than being in the room with people playing music. And it reminds me of something that a great educator, Loris Malaguzzi, said, which is about education, which is nothing without joy, just that. And we saw so much joy this week, last week, today, when the kids performed. You know, it's fabulous. So we're just very happy to be a part of it and to take that joy back with us when we go on the road. And sometimes it's easy to forget, you know, that feeling, but it's gonna last with us for a while. So, my name is Johnny, this is Michael, Nick, and Colin, and Nick will tell you a little bit more about what we just played and the piece you'll hear next.
Great, thanks, Johnny. The other great thing about being a musician is that there are receptions, actually, that quite a few of them, it seems, but there's one in particular that I'm drawing your attention to, which is set up on the veranda behind me, so that's for all of us to join afterwards, after we're done with the Schubert Quartet. From the looks of it, it's real stemware, so that bodes well. So we hope to see you. Johnny mentioned, you know, like, what happened in this room this afternoon with all the student quartets that were playing. So much beauty that was on display, all kinds of beauty. And you know, this is kind of like a difficult word to define, really, what that means. You know, something, Colin, you often talk about this, like in terms of what a string quartet does. It's not just an automatic pooling of resources, it's about actually crossing boundaries, right? And to borrow your line, the boundary that exists between you and your instrument, right? And then once you have that boundary, you know, it's between you and the others in a quartet, right? And then it's ultimately between the quartet and the audience. So even that idea of beauty actually is because it's overcoming that kind of diversity and dichotomy. Crossing borders and doing things that seem impossible. And that was what was beautiful, I think, about this afternoon, is watching the kids just kind of cross those boundaries and kind of put that really under the fire of the moment in the live room playing for everybody. So that's just great. I love that. Jonathan Swartz mentioned a little bit about Osvaldo and the idea of perspective. And this is another thing that music really helps do, is to cross borders. And so music, when we think about what is beautiful in music, well, maybe music is often trying to do a few things at the same time. And that is actually beautiful because it actually represents the human condition pretty well. In Osvaldo's case, by the way, Osvaldo was here this week. He came to visit. We're friends with Osvaldo, and he is working on a new string quartet for us, which is really exciting, so we might bring that around next time. But his piece is all about the perspective of looking at planet Earth from the heavens and how beautiful that is. But actually, the closer and closer you get to the surface, actually you feel the ripples and the conflict. But actually, because those things coexist, actually it creates this incredibly beautiful veneer in the piece. Also in the case with Schubert, I think this idea, which we're going to get to now, is the idea of dark and light being intermixed in a way, and sometimes so much so that actually sometimes the dark parts make you feel happy, actually, or bittersweet in some ways. And I think that's just all over the idea of this quartet. And so I think before too much longer, I think we should give it one last tune and jump in to this. Robert Schumann actually called, referred to the work of Schubert as just Schubert creating novels of heavenly length. I think that applies pretty well to this definitely.
Thank you.